I'm the type of person where I very easily could like go back into like how I felt, and I don't want to do that because I moved past that, and mom and I have a better relationship now, and so I just don't, I guess, go into the details.
I love my mom very much. Like, it's been hard to not have a good relationship with her. And really, that's what I want. I just don't think that the way to have a good relationship and to have a healthy relationship is through constantly discussing this and like bringing new people in to talk about it. I think it's just to move on.
Well, I think the more you talk about something like this, the more it like continues to make an impact on your daily life. Like for you, it's different because it's something that you talk through and like you, it helps you feel better, but for some people it's pretty unhealthy. And so I think that's another reason why we don't just talk about it all the time or even ever, because it's just something like, maybe it's something
to
better.
It's a non-issue.
Yeah, maybe it's just something to just better like live past, you know?
Yeah.
And just forget about.
So like I've never really told anybody like my story and everything that had happened because it's embarrassing. It's so shameful. I feel so stupid. So like I get it. Like even me as a victim, like I never wanted to talk about it.
Yeah, I'm sorry you had to go through that. Like I can't imagine the emotional toll it would take, you know?
I was at the same place. I did not want to talk about it. You know, I wanted to run away and hide and not even deal with it. You know, because it is embarrassing and, you know, shameful, and you don't want to admit that you'll let this happen to you.
They, like, the feelings that they're going through are still real, and, like, we still need to validate those feelings. Like, I think that that is really important, that, like, even though it might not be a big deal to us, it is a big deal to them, and it did happen to them, so their feelings are completely valid. And for them, I can't imagine. I still can't imagine what it was like for them. And so I do feel for them. I think it's a hard situation to be in. And I think that to have people understand that your emotions are valid is very important.
I'm glad you have a support group of people to like go through. Like, so like, even though it doesn't bother you in your daily life, like maybe if something does come up or like you have harsh feelings, like you have people to go to, maybe even people that don't live necessarily around you, but you could just call up. I think that's really
right,
awesome.
Or just text,
like a support,
or like,
system, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
Before we came here, Mariah and I had discussed how we wanted to go about the situation. And I knew Mariah didn't want to talk very much. And so I offered up to pretty much continue the conversation and like lead the conversation.
Yeah, I don't really have much of anything to contribute to this conversation.
It was different for me because I was just recently separated from my husband, so I was so vulnerable. Yeah. I was so lonely and just an evil person, just fed on that.
Your vulnerability.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And just pure evil. Just there was nothing gained from what was done to me.
Does this person try and still insert themselves into your life? Or
not as much as they do Meri. Not even close. And I'm thankful. I mean, I'm sorry that happens to her, but
yeah,
not even close.
There was a time that I was really scared of her, you know, and I got to the point in the situation that I'm like, you know what, I'm taking my power back and I'm not letting her win. You know, I'm not letting her mess with me anymore.
Like, honestly, the whole reason that I came is because I just wanted to validate Meri with the parents. And I think that they realized, like, you know, a lot of the things that Meri was saying are exactly what happened to me.
I think mom wants me to talk to Christy because she wants me to validate her in feeling like the victim.
Like, honestly, I know that it's crazy and it's psycho and you have to live it to know it and the hurt and to understand where she and I come from. You just have to have experienced it.
Something bad happened to her. But she also played a role in that. And she's trying to get me to see that she's completely the victim, and I don't see it that way. I love her, and I am sorry for what happened to her, but
she still played a part.
She still played a part in this.
I lived in fear for a really long time because the catfisher always dictated everything that went on between me and him. You know, he would throw a hissy fit and hang up on me, and then she would appear and be like, well, you better call him, and you better say this, and you better say this. That's the only way you're gonna fix it. Trust me, I've known him for 20 years, and if you don't say it, you know, it's never gonna fix it.
Controlling much?
Yeah, for sure.
I think that she forgets I was there when all of this was happening. And it was hard on me. It was hard on my family. It was hard on her too. I'm not saying it wasn't. And I explicitly said to her, you can be tricked online because you don't know who these people are. She still did it, and then she still wants me to think that she's the victim.
I feel stupid when I tell the story, and you don't know why you did the things you did. Like, in hindsight, I'm like, why did I do all those things? I don't understand.
I remember so many times, like, during the whole thing that I was, like, I would say to myself, what are you even doing? You are a smarter person than this. Why are you letting these people control you? And I just kept going right along with it because I was so scared of them.
Yeah.
I didn't know how to get out of it.
I didn't either.
I don't know. Recognizing where I've been wrong has been so beneficial for me to, like, grow in my relationships. And saying, you know what, hey, that was kind of my bad, you know? That's on me. Owning that has made me feel like I've grown as a person, but then even grown in that relationship. And I think that if mom were to recognize that and to say, hey, you know what? Yeah, I was wrong. Instead of constantly saying, I'm the victim, this was done to me, then I think that would be a lot easier for us to kind of grow from and move on from, you know?
Like, and it's harder to forgive someone who doesn't just admit to their faults.
Well, there's something wrong in, like, going on with her. Like, something had to have happened in their childhood or their adulthood that made them think the way that they do to be able to do this to other people.
With no regard for other people, yeah, or their feelings.
There's something
wrong. Like, it's strange. And children. My children were involved.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm seeing that Mariah's really not interacting much. I'm not sure exactly what's going on in her head, but I hope that she's hearing. I hope that she's hearing it.
Well, anyway, this is so boring.
Yeah.
I'm just so over it. Like, why are we still talking about this?
It was so 2015.
Yeah. Exactly. So, yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah.